Welcome to Italy, and this is MV Augusta's new 1090RR, and we've brought it right into the lion's den here in Bologna, home of Ducati, to see how it goes against Ducati's Streetfighter S.
Both have multi-adjustable suspension, lightweight wheels, Brembo radial brakes. These are the ultimate exotic bikes, super bikes, stripped down for the road. And what we're going to do is put them through the paces in northern Italy, around Bologna, up on the mountain roads and in the inner city traffic, and we're going to give you a verdict and tell you which one comes out on top. The end of our day in Bologna in northern Italy. Now, I'm not going to lie, we've not pushed these bikes to their handling limits, but we have rolled them in a real world scenario. City streets, dual carriageways, country roads, wet and dry, and we've had some good fun. Michael Guy, World Tour Bike Reporter, your little verdict so far of the two bikes?
Well, I mean, on paper you kind of think they're going to be quite similar, but they really are quite drastically different.
Yeah.
I love the punch and low down punch of the Ducati. It's just on the throttle, it's just the power is just there and it's instant. But it is hard. It does just feel like a superbike without the fairing.
Yeah, yeah.
Whereas this, the MV, is quite refined. It almost kind of feels they cross paths with the Japanese at some stage. It's quite a rounded package. The seat's a lot more comfortable. The handlebars are, you don't feel quite so over the front of the bike. I'd like to do more on both, to be perfectly honest.
Yeah.
In terms of leaning them over a bit more and going around a racetrack. But yeah, the characters are very different, and the end product is quite different. So it kind of depends what you want. If you really want a full-on sports bike, the Ducati is the way to go. If you want something that you can live with on a day-to-day basis, you've got to go towards the MV, I think.
It's a difficult decision.
For sure.
MV have made a huge step with the new Brutale. The old bike was uncomfortable, it was cramped, it was harsh, the feeling was a little severe. Yes, it was very quick, but in the real world it just didn't work. However, they've rectified all those problems. It is now comfortable, it is user friendly, the fueling is spot on, the brakes are good, the seat is comfy, you can use this bike every day. And as Michael Guy said correctly, it's almost Japanese-like, which makes the decision between the Streetfighter and the Brutale an incredibly difficult decision. It might just come down to looks and price. And if you've got a choice between either bike, you're on for a winner.